Fucking great, dude. We could choose a lot of these. What the fuck are these jerseys? Hockey jerseys? Yeah, all these are kind of crappy. Fuck, play next game. Been talking for no reason. Take home some money. Fuck your money, bitch. Fuck yo money.
Once they take the floor, they're one single.
Well, guys, the mark.
Great vision, David. Thank you. And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats.
We got it.
And suddenly his feel for the three-point shot has left him. It's been a tough go the past five games. The percentage from long range, not close to what it was earlier. But he's not going to give up on it, and he'll try to get it going.
Here are the starters for Los Angeles. The two stars, George and Leonard, fill up the forward slots. Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. And for the Spurs, it's Aldridge at the power forward with Pirtle at center.
They babuse that Aldridge matchup, that's for sure.
And it's Walker in at the two guard. Plenty of games still ahead, Brent. Some discussion about shortening the regular season. I don't think that's going to happen.
I don't think it's going
to
happen.
Would you like to see it happen?
I like the, there's some percolating
okay, ideas go out
there that it might, and the idea of a 70-game season to me, it sounds really healthy. It sounds healthy for the players.
Healthy is a great word to use.
It sounds healthy for the coaching staff. It sounds healthy for the league, and it sounds healthy for the competition that you're going to get. Those 70 games, that can be some elevated play throughout the course of a regular season.
That's a great number. Leonard, no
stupid.
Defense better tighten up on the mid-range. They're much, much tighter. You expect him to make every single one of those.
The pass to Pirtle. There's the three. And it's DeRozan missing.
And we so Beverly
will bring it up for the Clippers. A nice shot by George.
Now Paul George showing his offensive confidence right there. Just letting that one go as soon as it touches his hands.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Leonard with the steal.
Oh, my God.
As the Spurs gain possession.
Look, Kevin, I'm all for the crowd interacting with the players, but not so much the players interacting with the crowd. That one, errant pass.
White against Beverly. White the pass to DeRozan. Over George. DeRozan. That's good.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Here's Williams. They grab their own miss. And Pirtle sends it back.
Wonderful anticipation from Pirtle on that one, positioning himself perfectly to send that one back.
The Spurs have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Outside DeRozan. If you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Excellent D there from George.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers.
Let's go, bro. Kawhi, pop it off, baby. Let's get it.
Looks so different when Kawhi Leonard is on the floor and when he's knocking down shots like this.
And White kicks to Walker. Passes it to Pirtle.
Pocket six. Pass to Aldridge. And that's going to be a treble.
And while we've got a chance, let's check out the stats for Lou Williams. Averaging about 11 points, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. And to be honest, not quite the numbers you've come to expect from a player of his caliber.
It's been a bit of a roller coaster, an up and down stretch for him right now, but don't worry, team. He'll be back out there and feasting in no time.
Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Outside, White. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Here's Aldridge on the mark with the 15-foot.
Aldridge is cheese, dude.
In mid-range as a big, LaMarcus Aldridge is a great shooter.
Here's Williams. And there it is for him. Williams has got his second basket.
Working his way for a high percentage look. That's just smart basketball.
Man, that's a peanut possession right there, a masterpiece, especially when the defense is not a factor.
Aldridge, bucket number three. He's a perfect 3 for 3 to start.
This can make it so much easier for your teammate when you throw that lead pass that gets to him right on the money, whether that's on the run or in the shooting pocket.
Williams inside the line. And he overshot that one, missing.
But he's a guy they count on to produce from the mid-range. He doesn't miss too many open looks from there.
And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. A 29th pick in 2017 by the Spurs. Their injuries last year created an opportunity for Jarrett White to show Greg what he can do with steady minutes.
And White at 6'4", capable of manning either guard spot. A shooter, a playmaker, and an all-defensive team in college. He is definitely a keeper.
And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Clippers. 4-point game. Going to keep rolling here following the win against Memphis.
And you got to love a team.
Okay. Woo-woo.
On the road. Take good shots and knock them down with confidence.
Well, awesome to see in that last game how the motion in their offense didn't stop because they were in some hostile territory.
Damn. Oh, nice, too.
White the pass to Purdy. To the inside. Stolen by George.
Stupid, let's go.
Leonard attacking. That's good, and he's now 3 for 4 from the field.
And for a player who didn't enter the league with breakdown ability off the dribble, guess what? Kawhi will break you down.
And White kicks to Aldridge. Surveying the floor. Let's it go from 11. Kept alive. It's deflected.
Let's go.
Williams against Walker. With the teardrop, Williams can't hit. Spurs trail by 8. Right side to Walker. They double team Walker. Pass to White. That's tipped. Outside Leonard.
It's cold. Oh, why?
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. And Brent, as you know, there aren't many players that can set a tone for a team, but Patrick Beverley is one of them.
And Patrick Beverley always embraces that role about setting the tone defensively on an opposing team's point guard, making sure that tonight, if you're going to beat the team that Pat Beverley plays on, you're going to have to go through that.
Rudy Gay's checked in for the Spurs.
And the effort never stops with him.
No, Timmy, send me that new. Thank you for the follow. I don't know if you're still in here.
Defensive end, and that's what guys feed off. He gives the effort down.
I appreciate for the follow, my guy.
The shot's good.
I did not see that. Sorry, until 2 minutes ago.
Right now, especially on the interior.
I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it.
Beverly against White. Outside, Walker. The pass to Gay. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Here's Aldridge.
Shit out of here, boy.
Outside Leonard.
Oh.
Legion. 6 points for him.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by White.
I know people can't see you.
Damn, still a 10-point game? Alright, Spurs.
DeRozan against Leonard. DeRozan passes to Purtle. And here's White. Outside, Walker to the middle. Here's Aldridge. Five on the clock. Tipped away. And now it's Leonard.
They tell me to leave assignment, bro, but I'm trying to double team Aldridge on Lou Williams. Like.
Then there's Derek White. Then it's DeRozan. And it's Walker in at the two spot. That's the San Antonio five.
Kawhi's like, I'm showing out on these Spurs. Fuck you mean.
George against Walker.
He's showing out. Let's go. Give him a PG. Let's go, PG. Let's go.
Gets the bucket. George has got the lead up to 14 now for Los Angeles.
Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling now.
White against Williams. And it gets
Ooh, White's their foul.
Two shots coming up.
Here's a look at some stats for Purtle. Over the last 10 games or so, he's really shown up. Sixth in shooting percentage, and he's also ranked in the top 10 in blocks per game. No trespassing when he's in the lane.
And back to his phenomenal efficiency from three, top 10 in the league. His consistent shooting creates so many open.
All right, bro, come on now.
And both free throws good for White.
And last season for the Clippers, it was a collection of smaller guys who played big.
Well, they're very effective with those kind of lineups with shorter, very effective offensive players out there. And Lou Williams being a catalyst for what they were doing coming off the bench and providing a spark. You know, in the fourth quarter, there was always an opportunity for the Clippers, if the game was close, to rely on Lou Williams to get the job done.
Greg, I'm just so impressed with the level of finesse and craftiness that Lou Williams always plays with.
And Kevin, you don't stay a perennial sixth man of the year candidate at Williams' age without having more than a few tricks up your sleeve. He's so good in tight spaces and can find.
I don't know where I was blocking, but
where others just have to kick it out.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, Lou Williams won sixth man of the year for the third time last season. He joined Kevin McHale and Detlef Schrempf as the only players to win the award in consecutive seasons.
Fuck off, me little bitch.
The most career points ever scored off the bench. Maybe they should just name this award after him. Kevin?
David, I'm all for it. Thank you so much. And boy, is he in good company. Walker dishes to Aldridge. Williams against White. Faster pace now, Brent, in the NBA. This has become an endurance sport, and well-conditioned athletes are a must.
Obviously, Kevin, over the past couple seasons, the pace has picked back up. It's very reminiscent of the early 80s when you had the Lakers running, the Denver Nuggets running.
Yes.
You have these teams that are just flying up and down the floor. So as a fan, I think it's a wonderful opportunity, especially the closer you can sit, to watch a Russell Westbrook, to watch a Paul George, to see a Giannis get up and down the floor with such fluidity and grace and skill set. So the game opening up has also opened the eyes to the fans about just how great the athleticism of NBA players is.
Walker against Williams. It's tipped.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Here's Harkless for second effort, and he sinks the layup. He's got 12.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to to block out.
Yeah, that pops your confident balloon out there, just completely deflating when plays like that happen.
Walker in the post, defended by George. San Antonio again missing.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Now you can make a case that Lou Williams is at his best in that kind of situation, dynamite in transition.
White with it. Williams picks him up. White drives in, and he banks in the layup. White's got 7 now in this quarter.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
Here's George, and it's Paul George with the finish.
Damn, man, he fell.
Paul George, get up. Look at the guys on the bench loving it from PG.
Spurs trail by 18. Here's White. 9 points in the game so far. Here's Aldridge. And he can't bank that one in. The Clippers shooting indicative of smooth offensive play. Up at 60%. They're a machine from the floor. Oh, and the jam by Harkless.
What awareness there from Kawhi, waiting for his teammate to break free and then finds him.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
On the wing, DeRozan, defended by Harkless. From the wing, no good that time.
And another miss. Oof. He's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right.
Well, once Paul George gets in that deep, get out of the way. He's coming right at you.
Spurs have gone 8 of 15 since we began the second quarter. Excellent shooting. Here's White. Drills it from outside. White's got 12 in the game.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Here is Williams. 10 points for him. Fires from deep. DeRozan with the rebound.
Teammates right now covering up for the type of off performance he's having. In terms of scoring, this has not been his best night.
And George, here we go. Shoots over White. And no good. Trying to use the glass. Spurs trail by 19. From deep, Walker. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
Well, that's 2 bombs in a row from long range.
And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Clippers. 22 is their biggest lead. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. That game marks the first half of a quick 2-game homestand.
And I like that they're not settling. Getting the ball on the interior, 8 of their last 10 coming that way.
Leonard against White. Outside DeRozan. Shot clock at 5. And he tries off the glass, but it's no good. Los Angeles leading by 18. And Kawhi Leonard with the slam.
Steady strides in Kawhi Leonard being more and more comfortable as the go-to scorer for this team.
I might get me triple-double here.
Now DeRozan, defended by Harkless. Aldridge left side. White against Williams. White the pass to Aldridge. Double team on Aldridge. Here's White. And a great assist by Aldridge as that one goes in. 14 points for him.
I know he tends to be a shoot-first guy at this end of the floor. Aldridge with a great pass there.
Williams kicks to Leonard. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. Down low, deflects the pass. It's off his foot, and it's being called a kickball. Rudy Gay's checked in for the Spurs. Bryn Forbes comes in for White, and Los Angeles making a change here as well. Green, he's checked in for Kawhi Leonard. Pass to Harkless. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Yeah, nice job of drawing the contact and creating opportunities at the line.
The Clippers shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight. A different look now for San Antonio. Lyles checked in for Aldridge. Damari Carroll comes in for DeMar DeRozan. That's Mills in for Walker. The Clippers also making some changes. And Trez Harrell, he's checked in for Harkless.
Landry Shamet comes in for George. And it's Patrick Beverly in for Williams.
Game. And the rejection by Harrell.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
For Los Angeles, they have had 7 opportunities at the free throw line and made good on 5 of them.
This season, in general, has not been kind to them at the free throw line. Only about 71%.
And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started to play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second.
Mills with it. 9 points last game. Releases.
What a defender apparently is. He's just so active down there. The hands, the feet. He's just a menace.
And through the first half, a pretty lopsided.
Kevin, thanks so much. Kawhi, you...
Thank you, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime. And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. Kawhi Leonard really has his fingerprints all over this one.
What a menace he was on defense through the first 2 quarters, just disrupting everything.
Yeah, and that's exactly what he wanted to do out there. Everyone he guarded looked uncomfortable.
Setting the floor for the Clippers, the two stars, George and Leonard, fill up the forward slots. Beverly and Williams, the guard tandem. And Pirtle sends it back. DeRozan surveying the D. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. DeRozan's got the first basket of the second half here for the Spurs. Clippers leading by 18. And here's Beverly. And Leonard has it in the corner. Let's it go from the wing. It falls for his 7th bucket of the contest. He's 7 for 9.
I love the patience, the tactical mindset of Leonard. He's so good at picking his spots, especially on the pick and roll.
Pirtle finds Aldridge. Back to Pirtle. Outside, White. From past the arc. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
Maybe he's thinking at this point, man, somebody's got to help me. I can't do this all by myself.
Pass to George. And Pirtle sends it back.
Well, they're going to try to search out for somebody that's got a hot hand right now. 1 of 4 to start the half.
George against DeRozan. He kicks to Pirtle. Outside, White. Over Beverly. And it's White missing. Los Angeles leading by 17.
Dude.
It's stolen by DeRozan. To the paint. Trying to find White. Gets it to
get that shit out of here, boy.
Deflected. Williams, that's for 2. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
That's what he gives you. A big-time presence on the glass.
And you know what, Greg? Once he gets his hands on it, he's not even thinking about kicking it out.
Oh, his competitiveness right now is why the teammates love him.
San Antonio again missing.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
Spurs trail by 21. Stolen by Beverly. Williams, that's good. Williams has got 14.
And I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen tonight. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively, turning into easy points.
Los Angeles leading by 23. Now, here's George. He's got 10. And he
goes in for the dunk.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
Murray's checked in for Lou Williams. Now DeRozan. And we know he can score. He's averaging around 21.5 points a game. He blocks it again.
And swatting shots away with ferocity.
G.A., he is not messing around in this one. Beverly feeling it out a bit, and the shot goes down.
Well, part of their game plan was to block out the noise and just stay focused.
Always a good sign of maturity and steps forward when you can take this kind of effort, focus, and concentration on the road to get a win.
San Antonio calls timeout. Brent, we hear this all the time. Good defense beats good offense. Do you think that's true?
I don't know how defense scores. So in today's game, seeing the juggernauts and seeing what we've seen, Kevin, quite frankly, as some of the best offensive teams, not only in the last 5 years, but in the history of the league, around the Houston Rockets and what the Golden State Warriors have been able to do. It's about equipping your team defensively to be able to stop that stylistically. But certainly every coach will say it comes down to defense, because that is something you can control.
The Clippers have gone a solid 6 of 11 when shooting here in the third quarter. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Well, it's the golden age of point guards, and Patrick Beverley trying to show that he belongs amongst them. Great awareness on that play.
Right up top, defended by Beverley. Nobody near game. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
You got to try to scramble the Jets right here and get that guy off the sweet spot. That's one of the best three-point shooters in the league.
Pope loose, and we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And San Antonio has possession. George with the bucket.
And it's coming easy for them right now. Five baskets in a row in the paint.
White against Beverly. White the pass to Aldridge. There's another block. And that's 9 blocks.
You know he's going to be coming hard for that 10th, too. And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
And so White will bring it up for the Spurs. Stolen by Beverly. Another shot. The shot comes out. Aldridge with some nice deep. San Antonio's gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Inside. And Aldridge slams it in.
This is such a great, aggressive, and confident scoring option right there in the interior.
Murray outside. It's George on the wing. Just 5 to shoot. Over Walker. And another one in the scoring column for him. He's 7 of 10 from the field.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
And White kicks to Gay. A hand on it. Here's Beverly. He's got 6. Goes back up. Some solid defense from Aldridge.
Well, that's how to protect the rim without fouling. Force him into an awkward release and a bit of an adjustment on the layup.
Murray against DeRozan. Over Murray. And another basket for San Antonio. Los Angeles has gone 0 of 2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Zubac, bounce pass. There's the pass to Beverly. San Antonio with the rebound. Gay's got his 4th.
contract structure for NBA first rounders, 2 years guaranteed, 2 years of team options, qualifying offer. Brent, should we consider changing that up?
I think it's working pretty well, Kevin. I think every front office is out there trying to find players out there that are giving you value beyond your contract. And that happens a lot when you're a team that has a first round pick, 1 through 10, 1 through 20, and you hit on a draft choice. You potentially could get 3 years and sometimes four when you have incredible players coming into the league as their first year turning franchises around. But a player that's providing way more value than the contract that they're getting at that time. So I don't see that changing much. It gives teams a long enough time to evaluate the talent coming in.
Seems to be working.
It does. And the players that prove it are looking at the calendar saying, could I fast forward 3 years? Because I really like to cash in on what I'm doing for you.
Trey Lyles out there with Rudy Gay. Then there's LaMarcus Aldridge. Then it's Damari Carroll. And it's DeRozan in at the one spot. That's the San Antonio Five.
Are we sure that's the same player, guys? He looks completely different. What confidence he's playing with. And look how engaged he is on both ends.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jakob Poeltl. That's his first foul.
You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Williams passes to George. And out of bounds as the Spurs gain possession. Here's White. To the inside.
And the hell am I doing?
His impressive total. It's his ninth against 12 attempts.
Yeah, I remember a night when LaMarcus Aldridge put up 56 big ones on that scoreboard. When he gets going, look out.
And that one, good. And that's now 19 points for Williams.
And when the score is as lopsided as it is, and you can see they smell blood in the water, my man is going for the jugular.
Pass to Walker. Brent, with advanced analytics becoming commonplace in the NBA, which stats do you personally hold most value?
Well, it's amazing to talk about effective field goal percentage. I laugh a lot
which is everything shooting, free throws.
Yeah, well, I like to use true shooting percentage, Kevin, because that's where you adopt three-point shooting percentage, two-point shooting percentage, and your free throw percentage.
Everything.
But in talking to a lot of people around the league, general managers and coaches, I laugh inside to myself a little bit, like, oh, so now shooting's important? Like, what? Like now shooting's important
around the league? Right.
As if, you know, the time that you go out to start playing basketball, you grab a ball, you go towards the goal, and your goal is to make the shot. And so we're talking so much more about how much shooting is valued. Effective field goal percentage is tremendous, with true shooting percentage being not far behind.
And a strong finish with two hands.
I mean, he is tearing the defense apart, and let's face it, they have not brought their A game on that side of the ball.
Outside, White. To the middle, and stolen by Williams. Everly with the ball. Outside, George. A minute 50 left in the game. With the second effort, he lays it in. 24 points for him.
And that's a lesson for the D. Fight harder on the glass.
Yeah, you just can't afford to give up second chance opportunities again and again.
White the pass to Walker. Here's Purdy. Outside Aldridge. Can they get it? And it's the Clippers with the rebound.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Clippers.
This was a team performing to its fullest capability.
A hugely satisfying win. A game that not many will soon forget. And on the other side, one that I think most will try to forget.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win.
And as we get set to put this one to bed, a one-sided season series thus far, they've won two straight.
First free throw is good. You know, the NBA, not the only league with great players and great play. Talk about some of the other prominent leagues around the world. There's some terrific competition.
There's some great competition overseas in the Turkish leagues. Some very good players that play in the Russian league. There are some great players who are coming out of Australia, and we're actually seeing players now skip playing in the G League to go down to Australia to start their development and professional career. So when we talk about the world game, Kevin, we're not joking around. It's it's a very real thing, and we continue to invite the best players that we can find, and they come from all over.
And here's Los Angeles. Good momentum, 8 straight points. Pass to Magruder. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. The feed now to Beverly, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it.
Yeah, that's a tough one, Kev. An experienced player in the pro game shouldn't be making that pass.
27 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Now here's Mills, guarded closely to the wing right side.
Oh, fuck me, I'm so tired. Dude, I'm about to get off, bro. I'm tired as hell.
Off on the layup.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell defensively very serious.
So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. They're coming to an opponent's building and dominate the way they did. They bring an awful lot of energy.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all over.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K.
Hey, this is Kenny, man. First, I want to say congrats. Triple-double. Incredible night. But I'm curious, were you aiming for that? It was something you were aware of?
Jack, come on now, man. If I'm any...
Told me that too. Kelly, shouts out to you, love.
Well, that got me thinking, how much does setting new career highs mean to you at this stage in your career?
You know, guys, it's funny. I was just talking about this.
Good stuff. Thanks, Che.
Oh, no problem, guys.
You guys were firing in all cylinders tonight. I was wondering if you could talk about your defense. How were you able to stop those guys from getting all those shots that they wanted?
Dope game plan from the coaching staff.
Congrats on the win, Che.
Thanks, Patty. I appreciate that.
You look like you were really focusing on setting up your teammates tonight. Was that a point of emphasis for you, or more a matter of making the right play at the right time?
I mean, I wouldn't call it a point of emphasis.
So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, but I'm better. Like, I got up or something. I'm tired as shit. So I'll see you guys later. Adios.